The missiles tore through the Ukrainian military academy at 9 o'clock this morning, just as lessons were starting, leveling huge parts of the complex and killing dozens instantly. Army medics battle to save the injured.
Тримайся, тримайся.
Hold on, he shouts. You're a good lad. Tonight we arrived in a stunned city. The emergency services of Poltava could do little more than clear up the wreckage. We met Makita, a cadet who was inside the training center when it happened. The second missile hit 3 seconds after the first, he tells us. I ran outside. There was smoke and dust everywhere. Lots of people were outside having a cigarette, and many of them were killed. Yana, one of the many locals whose windows were smashed. Ukraine has taken a body blow too.
It's very hard. I take it personally. My husband is fighting on the front line. Soldiers have died here, and I know there are still soldiers still under the rubble. Their wives are waiting for them.
Then, as we were moving location, another air raid alert blared, and the instant fear of another possible hit here.
The air raid sirens have just gone off once again, and so a lot of the emergency services who are inside the building clearing out the debris have now moved out, even though there are still some people we know underneath the rubble.
President Zelensky condemned the attack, calling the Russians scum, and promised to get answers.
I have ordered a full and prompt investigation into the circumstances of what happened. All necessary services are involved in the rescue operation. I'm grateful to everyone who's been saving lives from the very first moments following the strike.
President Putin had vowed that punishment was on its way after the incursion into Russia a month ago. And it seems it arrived today, in seconds, in the deadliest attack on Ukraine for a year.